Flanked by the Filipino Workers Center, Los Angeles City Attorney Mike Feuer dropped a multi-million dollar lawsuit on a Filipino home care agency operator, claiming that they were paying workers $5.50 an hour, nearly half of the city's $10.50 minimum wage.
We allege the defendants systematically denied as many as 200 or more home health care workers, hardworking men and women, mostly Filipino immigrants, the minimum wage and overtime to which they were entitled by law.
Feuer says Emily Nishi, who owns Health Alliance Nurses Corp. and Hand Home Care Providers, Inc., charged clients between $170 to $250 for a 24-hour day. But workers were paid between $100 to $125 per 24-hour shift. Feuer adds that even at $250 a day, that cost does not cover California's wage and overtime laws. He says the practice went on at least 4 years, but workers were afraid to speak out. The Filipino Workers Center and Association of Filipino Workers brought this case to the city attorney's office 3 months ago. But this lawsuit was a year and a half in the making. The defendant was the subject of protest in December of 2015. At the time, Nishi, who was confronted by the protesters outside her then office, said the workers were independent contractors, whom she claims to have been paying $10 to $14 an hour. After that, the case was brought to the Labor Department before being filed in civil court on Wednesday morning. While Health Alliance has since closed down, John Arison, the company's compliance officer, says that Hand Home Care is in compliance. He tells ABS-CBN News that the allegations against them are false.
This has been one of our biggest cases because we do know that she is one of the big violators who not only owes her workers possibly millions of dollars, but also that she really treated her workers very poorly and used a lot of intimidation.
Feuer is asking potential victims of any case to contact his office while the PWC runs the Empleo Pinoy program. Ultimately, the city attorney is not only targeting the home health industry. He's hoping to stop wage theft in all industries, especially in places where low-paid and immigrant workers are highly vulnerable to this nationwide multi-billion dollar epidemic. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.